Hello, I'm Atubo George, and listen, I've been sharing all week on this parable of the wheat and the tares that Jesus shared. It's very important. Now, Jesus explained that the sons of the kingdom are the good seed, and the children of the devil are the tares. Now, do you notice that even in the ministry of Jesus, he had both the wheat and the tares? See, Judas Iscariot was a child of the enemy. Now, you know, people don't know this. People think Judas was anybody could have betrayed Jesus. No, it's not true. It's not true. Judas, right from day one, Jesus, remember, the Bible says Jesus prayed all night before he chose the 12. Now, you think he didn't know what he was doing? And in John chapter 6, Jesus, you know, when Jesus preached about eating his flesh and drinking his blood, the Bible says many of the disciples from that day stopped following Jesus. And then Jesus looked at the 12 and says, would he also go away? And Peter spoke up and says, to where? He says, you have the word of life. And Jesus replied him and said, haven't I chosen you 12? And yet one of you is a devil? And John actually said that because he knew who it is that should betray him. So don't think it was a mistake. Don't think the devil just entered one of them. No. Jesus knew he had both the wheat and the tares in among his disciples. He knew. Judas was never a child of God. He was a child of the devil. So say, how? Oh, yeah, you don't know this? See, there are people in this world that they are children of the devil. They were planted in this earth by the devil. And there are people in this world that are planted in God, by God himself. There are people on this earth who cannot trace. You know, we all know, at least, if you read the Bible and you believe the Bible, you know that the first man that ever came to this world or ever created, the first man that was created was Adam. Now, this whole generation came from Adam. But there are people in this life who, if you trace their genealogy, it will not get to Adam. It's going to stop somewhere. Yes, there are people like that. Now, those are the children of the wicked one. Are you following me? And their purpose for being on earth, and now not just on earth, even in the church, their purpose is just to cause an obstruction. See, now the devil's purpose is this. He is doing everything to prolong the days of Jesus, to prolong his days, because he knows his time is short. So he's trying to prolong the day of Jesus' coming. Are you getting me? That's what he's trying to do. But you see, Jesus is wiser. The wisdom of God is wiser than the devil. Now that's why I tell you, the tares do not really affect you. You can only be affected by the tares, that's the children of the wicked one, if you take your eyes off Jesus. If you don't take your eyes off Jesus, then you will never be affected by the tares. Say, how do I keep my eyes on Jesus? Very simple. See, this is the reason the Holy Ghost was given to us. Jesus himself said, now get this, he said, it is good for you, or it is better for you that I go. Because if I don't go, the Holy Spirit will not come. Why would Jesus say it is better? Think about it. Meaning being with the Holy Ghost is far better than being with Jesus. Now, even if they are the same, they represent the same, they do everything, the Holy Ghost is not going to say anything different from what Jesus would have said. But you know, this is the reason. Jesus could only be in one place at one time. At a particular time, he could only be with one person. But the Holy Ghost is in the United States, he's in India, he's in Russia, he's in Antarctica, he's in Australia, he's right here in Africa, he's just everywhere with every one of us, saying the same thing Jesus would have said. Now hear me. In your life, if you are not being led by the Holy Ghost, and you say you're a Christian, You say you're a member of the church of Jesus Christ. Jesus said, I will build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Now, if you are not being led by the Holy Spirit, then you need to ask yourself, am I part of that church that Jesus is building? Because how is he building his church? He is building his church by instructions, by his teachings. Not a man's teaching, not like I'm doing to you now. No, that voice that you hear early in the morning explaining scriptures to you. That voice that is saying something in your heart. You know, you're just lying down there and someone is just talking to you and say, do you know when Jesus said this and this is what it means and this is what it means? Who do you think that is? That's the Holy Spirit. Now, when that is taking place in your life, according to John chapter 15 and verse 3, it says something is going on. A pruning is taking place. A cleansing is taking place. According to Ephesians chapter 5 also, a cleansing is taking place. Now, that's what you should be looking out for in your life. Once that is happening in your life, then you know that you are part of the church that Jesus is building. If this is not happening in your life, I'm sorry to say, you may just not be part of the church that Jesus is building. And if you're not part of the church that Jesus is building and you claim to be in the church, then you may just be a child of the wicked one. Especially when you find out that your life is causing an offense. Your life is not representing the kingdom right. Everything you do, you tell lies so easily. You do all manner of things. I mean, things that are despicable. Things that you can't hear that a normal human being does. And that's what they do. They are causing offense. Jesus said, the things that cause offense and are lawless. You can't be doing lawlessness and think you're a child of the kingdom. No, you're a child of the devil. You're lawless. You listen to nobody. Nobody can correct you. Nobody can talk to you. You are lawless. And you say you're a kingdom you're in the kingdom of God. Yes, you're in the kingdom of God, but you are a tar. And you will soon be rooted out. I'm not saying this to condemn you. I'm saying this to say, check your life. Just in case you are being strayed away, that you will come back and repent and get your life straight and begin to walk in the right path as God has ordained for you. Now, tomorrow I'm going to be concluding this and I'm going to share a very important scripture to you. Praise God. Have a wonderful day today. God loves you. You know that? Yes, he does love you. Praise God. Bye-bye.